Welcome to the Coastal Geology Lab Prep video. In lab today, you guys are going to be using a combination of Google Earth and some stream table experiments. So for this portion of your lab, you're going to be using this little plastic shoebox filled a little bit with some sand and some water. You're going to want to shape your beach so it's kind of piled up more on one side of your tank, as you can see here. And then try to make the angle of the beach as similar as you can to what you see here and in your lab manual. Now we're going to be doing two different simulations. We're going to do high energy waves and low energy waves. And with between each one, you're going to want to get that beach back to this angle. So it might be helpful to take a marker and then draw on your box approximately where you started so that you know where to reform it to and you know how it's changed. So take your wave paddle, move it on one side, and you'll first do some low energy waves on one side of your tank. Some low energy waves, do that for about 5 to 10 minutes, and then look at the sides, see how things have changed. Now I didn't go long enough, so you're not going to see much of a change. But before you do your second trial, you're going to reform your beach again. Try to make it as close to that angle that you started with as you can. And then you're going to make some higher energy waves, much bigger ones, in your tank for 5-10 minutes. And then look at the side of your tank, make your sketches, and make your observations. For this portion of your lab, we're going to simulate a certain type of coastline. You're going to make sure that you shape your sand so that it has these little points jutting out and then portions that are carved back in. Also, hopefully you notice that it's pretty steep on all sides here. Make sure that you have those nice steep cliffs present in your model as well. So once you've shaped your sand, it helps it if it's a little bit damp so that you can really get those nice steep cliffs. You're going to add some water to the bottom of your tank. Make sure that you've got your bucket below and you've got your tape sealing that hole. And you can see here that mine's actually leaking a little bit, so it's a good thing I had this bucket. So once you have everything all set up, your water's been added, now you need to put in some features and maybe some toothpicks in your landscape so that you can see where things have eroded and where things have deposited. So just put these just around one of these features for you to see, and then I can put in some army men here as well. Something a little bit larger to see. So once you have everything in place, you sketch what things look like at the start. What you are going to do is you're going to take your wave paddle, the end of your tank, and you're going to make some waves. I'm not going to go crazy. I'm going to make some small waves over time. And then you're going to take your paddle out and see what changes have occurred. Now, I didn't make my waves for very long, so not much has changed. But when you do it in lab, you're going to see a significant change because you're going to do those waves for a much longer period of time. So that's the first experiment that you're going to do. The next one, you're going to take all these out and we're going to reshape your beach so that it has a little bit more of a lower slope. We're not going to have the big steep sections. So what I'm going to do is move some of the sand around here so that the beach is actually at an angle in your tank. So I'm going to make that nice shape across here. Move the sand up out of the way. And you can see right now we've got a pretty steep side here. I don't want that. I want it to be a nice gradual slope. So I'm just going to scoop a lot of the sand up and out of the way. So we want this to be very similar to a real sandy beach. Move a lot of this stuff up out of the way. Make it a nice smooth angle. All right. So now that we have this nice smooth low angle beach, You can again put some of your toothpicks in some of these spots. Now, one thing to note is when you get into this area down here, because these waves are going to bounce off the edge of your tank, things are going to be a little funny here. So we're going to try to ignore what happens in this corner. Focus more on what's happening up here in the center of this beach. Now, one thing to note as you're making your waves here, make sure you're watching the sand grains along the beach front, because you're going to be noting where they go. Do they travel in one direction or another, or do they stay in the same spot? So we'll do the same thing, make those waves in the same spot towards the other end of your tank. Watch what happens to the water on the beach. And then watch what happens to the sand grains as well. And then make your sketches, make note of what happens to your beach over the time period you're making those waves. So the next portion involves the same profile. So if things have changed too much and you don't have that nice straight line, make sure you reform it. Make sure it's that nice low slope as well. And then you're going to take some man-made structures and add them to your little wave tank here. So the first simulation, what you're going to do is you're going to make some features that are parallel to your coastline here. So put one on there. And then you're going to go ahead and make your waves again for a period of time. You're going to watch where the sand goes, where you have erosion, where you have deposition. And then make your sketches where you had erosion, where you had deposition. And then the last portion, you're going to take your parallel feature, reform your beach a little bit here, so it's the same as it was. I'll just move these a little bit. And instead of having a parallel structure, you're going to put it perpendicular to the sand. And you can put one in, you can put two in if you like. Another block in there. Make your sketches, note where your toothpicks are, and then you're going to make your waves again. You might have to do this for a significant period of time, and that's okay. If you need a break, you can take a break. You're going to do this for a while. Note where the sand's moving to and from. And then you're going to sketch where your erosion was, where your deposition was. And make sure that if you're using colored pencils or maybe if you're doing X's for erosion, you put that down below your document in a key so that I know what your symbols and what your colors mean. So make sure every time you're sketching everything, you record everything that you see on that document that you're going to turn in and then answer the appropriate questions in your lab manual. So after you finish those trials, you can do the computer sections on Google Earth. And because of the shortness of supplies, you might have to rotate through each of these different experiments. They don't have to be done in order. All the stream table ones should be done together. All the wave profile ones should be done together. So make your observations and make sure you write everything down before you leave lab, and then email me if you have any questions.